All of you might have been following the ongoing farmers protest, and I think everyone might have gained enough knowledge on this protest. The similar way there are anti-citizenship amendment act protests in past year, and everyone across the nation might have noticed all these protests and studied this protest very carefully. What is the purpose of protest? The purpose of protest is to educate the people, and that is what these protests are doing. These are the protests which arouse the concerns of the nation, citizens of this nation, across the communities, caste, religion, sex, gender, and all those things. So what is it today we are going to discuss? Today we are going to discuss about the nature of these protests and how different these protests are. Even though they look very similar, one is anti-CAA, one is farmers protest. They look very similar to us, but what is the difference of this protest? What is the different nature of this protest? This is what we are going to discuss today. This is Randhir Rawla from IAS Gurukul, and let's move on to the topic. Without going into why farmers are protesting and why agitators are protesting against the CAA, we will just look at the nature of this protest. Let us look at the social impact this movement have been garnered across the nation. Anti-CAA protests have been started with a very wide agenda of giving citizenship to dispossessed people in neighboring countries. But later on, as the movement passed on, it has reduced to a single demand, that is citizenship to Muslims. A movement which has started with a wide and larger base has been reduced to a single demand, that is citizenship for the Muslims. And if you look at the farmers protest, it has started with a single demand, repeal of the acts. But later on, as the movement passed on, it has included workers, it has included laborers, it has included liberals, left. So it has become very inclusive. Anti-CAA protests have become exclusionary protests in the later part of the movement. At the same time, farmers movement has become an inclusive protest. So farmers are including each and everyone coming to them. This is one of the most basic difference. The other basic difference, if you look carefully at this protest, is anti-CAA movement is mostly a leaderless movement, whereas farmers movement is not. There are leaders in anti-CAA protest also. Yes, there are leaders, but the movement mostly is leaderless. Many NGOs, many civil society groups have supporting this movement. There is no single union or organization which represents these protesting people. Whereas look at the farmers movement. Several organizations came together and formed a single organization, and this is the organization which is representing farmers to the ground. This is how a movement is different. If you look at the Wall Street movements happened a decade back in United States, that is also a leaderless movement. And how did it conclude? It has concluded without any result. Let us look at the support base of these two protests. One is anti-CAA and one is farmers protest. Anti-CAA protest has garnered widespread support across the nation, but still majority of the Hindus could not support it, could not gain the trust of these people. Whereas farmers protest, irrespective of the religion, irrespective of the caste, gender, people are supporting this movement. Now let us take anti-CAA protests. What or which kind of political party supported this? The political parties which claim themselves as secular, which claim themselves inclusive, has supported this movement. None of the BJP allies has supported this movement. Even if they supported it very partially. Look at the farmers protest. The whole state of Punjab is behind this protest. Parts of Haryana, parts of UP, that especially Western UP, are behind this protest. The most trusted ally of BJP, Shiromani Akali Dal, has left NDA, and this gave impetus to farmers to fight for the right. But let us look at the optics of these movements. The farmers tried to show the hardship to the whole nation. Irrespective of the bone-biting winter cold, they stayed border of Delhi. And they set up camps across the borders, around Delhi, around Sindhu, Tikri border. And they stayed there for almost 2 months now. They are showing their resilience, resolve to the nation that we, the farmers of the nation, are fighting for our rights. Despite seeing similar situation in Shaheen Bagh also, these protests could not garner enough public support. The use of social media, the use of mass media, the presentation of their hardships has been different. Now let us look at why political backing is different for this protest. Muslims population constitute around 14% of India's population. Surely it doesn't have that impact in recent past. Now if you look at the farmers protest, We know India is a farmer-centric nation, and even today, many people, even though they are not directly involved in agricultural activities, the farming is their base. Many people staying in urban areas, their parents, their brothers, sisters might be working as farmers in their villages. So farming has a lot of electoral base, which can change and transform the election results. So the political impact of these farmers' protests is also huge when compared to Shaheen Bagh protests. That is the reason various political parties, though allies of NDA, had withdrawn from NDA to support farmers' movement. The other major difference of these protests is the economic impact. Having stayed for Delhi and closed borders for so many weeks, it is estimated that around 30-40% of trade has been declined in Delhi. And reports of CII also states that farmers' movement has been a huge economic impact, whereas anti-CEA movement did not see such huge impact on economy. Now let us look at the Supreme Court's take on this. During Shaheen Bagh protest and anti-CEA protest, Supreme Court had also formed a committee to negotiate with the protesters, but Supreme Court did not stay the act. Whereas in farmers' case, Supreme Court has stayed the act and similarly formed a committee of experts to talk to farmers and to explain the farmers the importance of these bills or acts. Supreme Court even criticized the government for its inaction or the way it handled the protest of farmers. Shaheen Bagh protest or anti-CEA protest, Supreme Court did not say any such thing. So having talked about the nature of this protest and how different these protests are regarding their nature and impact, what are the lessons do we learn from this protest? Why we study something is to learn from them. Any protest can't be worked on a singularity. Any protest to get a proper conclusion, it has to be inclusive. It should include many sections of society. What sections, you ask? It can be gender, religion, community, caste, creed, or any other section. That is what India's strength is, unity in diversity. Singularity is a problem in anti-CEA protests. The second is the leaderless movement. Any movement having no leader will dissipate very faster. If there is no leader, then some leader should emerge from the movement itself, because the leader becomes an image of the protest and it is the leader who represents the protest. The Champaran movement was success because of Gandhi's face. The civil rights movement in US was success because of Martin Luther King Jr. The Anna Hazare movement was considered to be success because of Anna Hazare. So any movement or any protest, for its success, it need a leader. It need a large support base. And that is what a movement is all about. Thank you so much.